while traveling through this world of sorrow. Oh,
stand and get our minds upon the Lord and worship the Lord today.
It was amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. I was
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Emily, you want to come sing? Well, this one stays on, I'll tell that.
I believe that's the one that's blue.
You might have to turn this one, that sure is, it's really loud. This one over here right here.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Well, the devil really been fighting here tonight for some reason. Well, which I know why, but praise the Lord. But you know, it's a constant battle, seems like every day you have to fight, face the devil, you know. Tell you one thing about it, honey, when we get to heaven, there ain't gonna be no devil over there, you know. Praise the Lord. Anyhow, I'm gonna sing a song and y'all pray for me. I'm gonna try to do it. I ain't done it in a long time. Can't do. Who am I? Praise the Lord. I'm gonna stay any day I do it.
He does it all the time.
far from glory, came and dwelt among the lowly, such as I. He suffered shame and such disgrace. On Mount Calvary took my place. Jesus was. battles. We have to suffer trials like he had to suffer. But you know, one day he said, well, he said, if you reign with me, that's what he said, yeah. Praise the Lord. He said, if you suffer with me, you'll reign with me. Y'all pray for me. I'm getting all tongue twisted. But you know, praise the Lord.
Thank you.
devil seems like he's trying to steal my voice.
Amen.
Trying to put a tickle on my throat, but it's going on anyways. You have your Bibles, if you turn to the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 35. It said, "In the same day when the eve was come, he said unto them, Let us pass unto the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships, and there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow, and they awake him, and said unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, Peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, Why are ye so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said one to another, What manner of man is this, that even the wind and the seas obey him? Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, as we come before you tonight, Lord, God, we bind the enemy, God, that's trying to come against this service. Oh, God, that I'm a willing vessel unto you, Lord. Oh, God, that you would use me how you see fit. God, that your anointing would come down, God, and that your words would be spoken, Lord, to touch the hearts, God, of those that are here. Lord, I thank you, Lord, and I praise you, God, for your presence, Lord. And I give you glory and I give you honor in Jesus' name. Amen. It's in 35 on through, it says, "And the same day when the eve was come, he said unto them, Let us pass over to the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there was also with him other little ships, and there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship. So it was now full." The disciples were they knew the water. They were very avid fishermen. They knew that they wasn't going to go out into a storm. They knew if the storm was coming, they sure wouldn't have went out there and sure wouldn't went out there to fish. And there was about, 300 boats out on the Sea of Galilee at the time. And then all of a sudden, here comes the storm. And it come without warning. They didn't know that this storm was coming. They didn't know that that the storm was coming that they didn't prepare for. And it came without warning and fear overtook them. Fear overtook the disciples. Sometimes in our life, sometimes the storms of life hit us without warning. Mm-hmm. And we don't know how to take it. We don't know what to do about it. Sometimes we try to do things in ourselves. Sometimes we don't look to the Lord for things like we should. Sometimes fear overtakes us. Sometimes we don't trust in the Lord like we ought to. Sometimes we doubt God. Sometimes we say, Lord, what am I going to do? But fear overtook them. And the Sea of Galilee, and the place that it is, it's about 680 feet below sea level, and it's down into a valley. And you got mountains all around it, and I say it's like the Valley of Decisions. When the storms of life come, you're down in the valley, and you don't know which way to turn or what to do, and your mind is so boggled, and sometimes you don't understand things. And it was down in a valley when the winds would come and to the top of the mountains, it was seeing such violent storms on the Sea of Galilee. Very bad storms that it probably took ships under. It probably done things to the people that were there. Sometimes we say, Lord, I don't understand this. There seems like there's no way out. Seems like there's no way of escape. Sometimes we just don't understand when life hits us in the way that it does. But it does. Storms are going to come all the time in our lives, as Christians or as non.
Amen.
The Bible says that that the just will suffer with the unjust. We are no different than anybody else, and the storms of life will hit us. It says that he was in the hinder part of the ship, which is Jesus, asleep on a pillow. And they awake him and said unto him, Master, carest not that we perish. When we're caught in the storms of life, isn't it so easy to say, well, God don't have control. Where's he at? Has he forsaken me? Well, what am I going to do? Jesus, I don't hear you. I don't feel
where you are. What am I supposed to do? I've done everything that I know to do on my own. I've got to find where you are. See, the disciples went to Jesus when they done all that they knew to do. And they went to him because they knew that he was the help. When things begin to really look bad, the disciples, they went to Jesus. Many times we try to fix these problems of life and these storms of life on our own. And we just mess them up even worse. Just like Jonah, when he went down to Tarshish instead of going to Nineveh, and he got on the boat. And what happened? A storm came. The storm of life hit him. And they were on that ship. And they went to Jonah, pray to your God. Pray to your God. Why? He already knew he was the problem. He already knew he messed up what God had for him. And he had to be thrown overboard and the storm ceased. Sometimes we get in the way of what God wants us to do. Sometimes we meddle in things that we shouldn't and let God take control of the storm.
Amen.
It says, and he arose, which is Jesus, and rebuked the wind. And he said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said one to another, what manner of man is this, that even the wind and the seas obey him? The disciples underestimated who Jesus was because they didn't see Jesus before rebuking the winds or rebuking anything. They didn't see that. They didn't know that Jesus had power over nature. They didn't see that. But what is our excuse? We know what Jesus' power is. We know that He will bring us through anything. We know that He'll never leave us or never forsake us. He will walk on the waters. He'll walk through the valleys. He'll walk through the fire. We'll not be burned. We will not be overcome by the problems of this life. He said, those that endure to the end shall be saved. We have a hope in this thing that we know that if we strive and we make it through, that Jesus said that we will endure the storms of life. We may have to endure sometimes. But God has made a way of escape. And when I get on through the message, you'll see how good that this story actually is. How the Lord has brought it to me. You know, there's many storms that has hit my life. And just a few, I'll say, I was in an accident in August of 26th of 2011. In a bad accident. Was out of work for 2 months. That's a storm of life because where am I going to get money from? How am I going to survive in my life? Well, on down the line, in October of 2015, my husband was incarcerated. That's another storm. Then on to down to the line, in February of 2016, I lost my job. My job went away. That's just some examples of the storms of life that can hit you here. We can also have spiritual storms of life that hit us. But as the natural storms of life that hit us, they're going to hit us regardless of who we are. Just like I said, it said in 1 Peter that the just will suffer with the unjust. And I began to meditate on this story. And I was laying in bed and the Lord had brought to me. You know, sometimes you look out and the sun is shining and it's shining so pretty.
Amen.
And you're walking and things are going perfect. Things are going so good and you're walking and you're just having happiness and peace and joy. And then all of a sudden, bam, here comes the wind. Bam, here comes the thunder. Here comes the lightning. Here comes the rain. And it's barreling down on top of you and you feel like you're so overwhelmed with life and you don't understand why this has hit you the way that it has. And then here comes the fog. And the fog is so thick that you can't see your way through it. You say, God, I can't see that way of escape. I don't know how I'm going to go through this. I don't know how I'm going to face. It may be sickness in your body that you may have to endure. It may be financial problems. It may be anything. It may be your children. Anything in this life that kind of goes against the grain can come up against you. But I'm here to tell you tonight, storms do not last forever.
Amen.
Storms will end. As you see, when the thunder and the lightning crashes and the thunder rolls and the rain comes, the storm eventually does end. Mm-hmm. The sun comes right back out again, and you start feeling the love of the Lord, and you start feeling happy, and you start feeling the joy that you once had before, and you're just going around telling everybody how happy you are and how God's moved for you, and God begins to bless. The storms don't last forever.
Amen.
The disciples, when Jesus told them in that first verse, He said, "Let us go to the other side." He never said that they was going to perish in the middle. He never said that they was going to drown. See, they didn't have the faith where they needed to have the faith, because Jesus went and said it in red print. We're going to the other side of this. We're not stopping here in the middle. You're not going to die. You're not going under. He says, we're going to the other side. See, there's always another side to this thing. Storms is not meant to last forever, and it's not meant to take you under. It can. It can take you under if you allow it to. But it does not. It's not intended to take you under. A lot of times storms that we go through in this life are so that Jesus can mold us into who He wants us to be.
Amen.
That's what storms most of the time are for. He's trying to build you up. He's trying to encourage you. He's trying to strengthen that inner man. That's what you go most time through storms for. Hallelujah. Sometimes we need to thank God for some storms. There are some things that I have wrote down. Spiritual storms. Some of them have to be rebuked or fought. It has to be took authority over. Just like Jesus, He took authority over the winds and the rains. And it ceased and there was a calm. Sometimes we have to take that authority over the enemy and tell that enemy where to go and to put him in his place. Sometimes he tries to come up against us to put us down and out, but we ain't got to stay there, see. We're going to rise above it because we have authority because Jesus Christ gave us authority. He told us that we're to tread upon serpents and tread upon scorpions, and we don't have to take anything that the devil brings our way.
Amen.
He's given us authority over that. Sometimes we have to seek shelter from the storm. Sissy had preached about King Jehoshaphat when he went into the battle with the Moabites and the Ammonites. The Lord said, "The battle is not yours, it is God's." And said, so "You will not have to fight this battle." Sometimes we are to stand still and see the salvation of God, and to trust in the Lord. Sometimes the best place to be with God is in His arms, when you're sheltered from everything. So sometimes in the storms of this life, we're to be sheltered in the arms of an Almighty God and let God take care of it. Don't mess with it. Don't do anything with it. But to stay in the arms of an Almighty God. Hallelujah. Let Him take care of it. Just like David, when he went before Goliath. He didn't go in David because the battle wasn't David's. The battle was the Lord's, and He took those stones. He says, "You may come at me with a spear and a sword, but or a sword and a shield, but I'll come to you in the name of the Lord." And He took it and He hit him right where God wanted him to, because he let God take care of the battle. Sometimes we need to get ourselves out the way and say, "God, I trust you to take care of this." We need to know what kind of storms that we're facing so we know how to deal with them. Sometimes we have to endure them. Paul had to endure a thorn in his flesh in 2 Corinthians. Even though he had to endure this, and he asked God to remove it 3 times, he said, "My grace is sufficient for you.
Amen.
That my strength is made perfect in weakness." Sometimes you have to endure the things of this life. Sometimes you have to walk through them. It may be for a month or two. It may be for a year.
Bless the Lord.
Sometimes you may have to endure it. But He said, "My grace is sufficient." My strength, not your strength, His strength is made perfect in weakness. Hallelujah. Just like I said, the storms of life can take you under if you let them.
Amen.
Peter, when he walked on the water, he trusted in Jesus for a while. He looked straight ahead. But when you get your eyes off of Jesus, and you get your eyes off your problem solver, you're going to go under. And Peter did. But let me tell you something. If you love the Lord and you trust in His ways, what did He do? Help me. And Jesus reached down and picked him up. Let me tell you something. These storms in this life are meant not to last forever. And I'm here to tell you tonight, I feel that in my spirit, that the storms are not going to last forever. They can't. They're not intended to last forever. Jesus said, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. When He said, peace, be still. God is going to calm some storms in some people's lives, and He's going to say, peace, be still. This storm was not intended to take you down. It was not intended to take you under, but it's going to bring you up. It's going to strengthen you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The battle sometimes is not ours. It's for Him. You got to hold on to Jesus and hold on to the nail-scarred hand. None of us are exempt from battles. None of us are exempt from storms. Just like I said, the just will suffer with the unjust. Nobody is exempt. No one enjoys to suffer. But in the hands of an almighty God, He uses them as tools. He uses these hardships to shape us into who He intends us to be. I got to listen to a testimony that a man was saying about a song that was written, and some of you may have seen it, but it touched me. And he said that this couple was at their wit's end. They had some storms of life that come knocking on their door, and they felt like they were crashing in with the storms of their life. They didn't understand why they was going through the things that they was going through. Their heart was broke. They were down and out, and they were sad, and they felt like there was no way out, and they didn't know how to pray anymore. All they could do was cry, and they felt like that they couldn't go on any further. And they got down in prayer. And they prayed, and Jesus showed up on the scene. You know how Jesus shows up on the scene? Just like when Jesus came to them walking on the water, when the storms was on the ship, and they got out there in the mist. But what did He tell them? He said, go to the other side. That's what He told them in that story too. Go to the other side. He didn't say they was going to perish in the middle of it. They didn't say that they was going to die. They weren't going to drown anything. He said, I'll meet you on the other side. They said that they had went as far as they could go. And Jesus showed up on the scene. And He began to write the words to, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. You know, we cannot walk this walk and this life without holding the hand of Jesus Christ, the one who bled and died for us, for me, for you. And I'm here to tell you tonight, if the storms of life have got you, took you under, felt like it's took you under, felt like you're drowning, felt like that you're down and you're out and you can't see above it, I'm going to tell you something. It won't last forever. This storm shall pass. It will pass. It will come to an end. But I'm here to tell you tonight that Jesus Christ is the best thing that can ever happen to you. Yes, the walk is not easy. It is not easy. You've got to go through some things in this walk. You've got to endure some things in this walk, because the Lord said to deny yourself and take up your cross and follow Him. And we have to bore the cross that Jesus carried in our own on this way. But I'm here to tell you tonight that Jesus loves you today. He cares for you today. He loves you. He wants you to make heaven your home. And He loves you. He died for you. He bled for you. No matter what you go through in this life, Jesus is always there. Sometimes we may not feel Him. Sometimes we don't understand where He's at, but He's right there. He's right there in the grips of our hand, telling us it's okay, you're going to make it. You're going to see it through. Hallelujah. The storms of this life are not meant to take you under, but they will come to an end. Hallelujah. I thank you for your attention tonight. And if there's anybody here that don't know Jesus, I'm asking you to please come to the Lord. He is, just like I said, he's the best thing that has ever happened to me and to anybody else that's in here. If we didn't have Jesus, where would we be today? We wouldn't be here probably. We'd probably be doing things in the world that can take us straight to hell. There is a hell, there's a heaven to gain, and there's a hell to shun. And I'm here to tell you tonight that Jesus loves you. No matter who you are, where you've been, what you've done, Jesus loves you. And he will help you through everything in this life. I've been through a lot of storms, and I've been through a lot of battles. Here in this life, seems like I have a battle anymore with my mind anymore. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus will take care of that.
Amen.
He will take care of it. He already seems like he has. He will take care of it. Hallelujah. And I thank you and for your attention tonight. And we'll turn it back over to Susan.
Becky, I mean, she did a really good job tonight. I really loved what she said about the storms. It's only for a time. It's only for a day. It could be for just a month. But eventually, it's going to be over. Eventually, Cece, we're going to see the bright skies out there that's no longer dark. And I thank God for that. I thank God. If there's anybody that needs prayer tonight, come and make your way up here. And give them all provision.
He said, why can't I bring you through this? Question after question. He said, but it feels like you've got no answer. He said, I am your answer. He said, this mind battle has come to a stop. Right now, he said, peace be still. Anybody else need prayer? If not, I'm going to ask Miss Emily to come up and close us out.